You'll also notice over here, I just created some categories, and then I stuck in, you can link out to other searches, other websites, to the internet. Here is Wikipedia's page on Easter, if you wanted to do that. I linked to the Elm database, the Encyclopedia Britannica article on Easter. So if you were, say, at a school, maybe you would want to come up with a room that has that fits around some curriculum you're doing. There might be a teacher who does a report every year at one of your public libraries on a certain subject. You could easily create a room that is geared towards that. I think we had a teacher that always did a project every year on old-time communication methods like the typewriter. And so the kids would come in and want all the books on transportation or communication. You could create a room that sort of has those pre-created for you. So then when you know, oh, they do that report every March, you can just turn the room on and then disable it the rest of the year so it's not visible.
Teresa, did you have a question?
Yep, actually I've got a Christmas room that I was working on last June when I thought we were going to go live in August, and I hid it because who needs a Christmas room right now? So I threw together the Easter room instead. So I've got links out to our Elm database here, Encyclopedia Britannica, and this is a persistent link that they provide. And then here's the Wikipedia page on Easter. The other thing you can do is you can, here's some links to Easter crafts. And it's just a website with a bunch of crafts. I've got a link to Pinterest Easter crafts. And then the other thing you can do that I didn't follow through all the way was you can share easy Easter crafts on Pinterest, links right from your catalog. You know, the idea is to keep people on your catalog and to create sort of pathfinders or navigation tools to compile information that you might have scattered in multiple places into one unified place, kind of the idea behind the room. You can scan, if you had a craft, you know, that you gave out at story time or whatever, you could scan that and make that a PDF link right on this page. And you can do that for some of the reading program stuff. I did cooking. So here is my deviled eggs recipe. I meant to scan my actual card, but I found one close enough on the internet. It doesn't have the paprika on top. So anyway. So I linked out to some recipes and some crafts from the Easter room. The other room that I kind of messed around with, just to give you an idea, and hopefully your creative juices are going here, is a more of a clearinghouse for jobs and employment. You know, here are links to all sorts of jobs and employment. You could set this search so that it is looking for books with, like, employment in the subject heading, resume, cover letter. I created three created searches over here. I've got a bazillion tabs open. Let me close some of these. So here's a search that pulls up all the books in, all over SELCO on resume writing. So you can do that. You know, I would have loved to have this when somebody comes in the library and says, I just lost my job. What do I do? Well, here's a whole section on unemployment and what you do. And these are linking out, you know, to the state of Minnesota's unemployment information. So it's a clearinghouse. That's kind of one use is like this. Different places in Rochester. Obviously, we could copy this room, stick it under your profile, and then edit it so that it covers whatever places in your community you want covered. You would need to give us the links, because I'm not going to know. So it would be collaborative, setting this up. So, and again, here's some stuff for our Elm databases, various books, Occupational Outlook. This is my favorite. Like, oh, typing skills. I need those. here's another search that is pulling how to do, here it is, cover letters. There's another one I think I had on there for job interviewing. So some of the ideas that I've had about rooms as I've been thinking about this are clearinghouse rooms, sort of like this job one, genre rooms. I showed you the mysteries one a little bit, sort of making it look at that Netflix-y type theme where you've got all those images that then click the individual title. So genre rooms, rooms geared towards certain age groups, so juvenile, teen, I don't know if you want to do a baby boomer room, so things that are of interest to boomers. So yeah, you would should be able to click this, and yeah, you're brought to your image, you can place your request, etc. Movie room,
sure.
So yeah.
Could we do a room where we could put
Boots
made in community?
Yeah, yeah, actually I've got, I mean, we would need your collaboration, right? Because I'm not going to know every book that's put into a movie, but we would be able to gear a room towards that, yeah. Actually, I've got on the mystery room, wherever it went. Hold on. I've got a section on there. You know, from screen to book, here's Sookie Stackhouse, and if we open this in a new tab to True Blood, and then this is a search of Sherlock Holmes materials, so I just created a search that was all the Sookie books, and then Sookie was True Blood, so here are the True Blood seasons, so you could do something like that, and you could adjust that so that it's the entire room instead of just one section. Here's the Sherlock Holmes room. And this has not just the movies, but there's the books in here somewhere. Yeah, here they are. So other ideas for rooms would be community event rooms, if you're doing a legacy event, if you're doing a one book, one city, award rooms, a room for My Heart Lovelace books, a room for Newbery winners, something like that, maybe Academy Award winner room. Different type of DVD rooms, if you want a nonfiction room, a fiction room, a how-to DVD room, something like that. History rooms, so a room that maybe covers a specific time period or a history room that covers multiple time periods. Health rooms or other rooms that highlight a collection in your library, like Alice, here, Alice, yeah, there she is. You have a parenting collection. So we can make a room that is just searching your parenting collection and highlight parts of that. Rooms geared towards specific school curricular disciplines. So somebody asked me over email a while ago, how do I find all the books about Minnesota? And not just about Minnesota, but she wanted all the Minnesota authors. She wanted Minnesota literature. That's something we could do a little more easily in a room than just the plain catalog because of how that information is spread around. Educational rooms, sort of like the job search room, but maybe more of how to do certain things with your Kindle. Tyler's actually got some of those how-to rooms set up. Do you have the e-book room? Oh, okay. There is an ebook room that has sort of all the OverDrive documentation, or we're hoping will soon, on there that would give you documentation on how to do things. Like we've created for the Need Your Discoveries, that's basically an instructional educational room. You could do something similar, you know, how to use the public computers at your library, that kind of thing. So, all right, I have not been paying attention to time. Oh, rooms for big events was my last big idea because the Super Bowl and the Olympics are coming up. Or, you know, we just had the fantastic State of the Union last night, so which Twitter was really fun if you were following hashtag. It's always amusing with political things. You could have a room that is sort of, you know, about sports or geared towards kids and the Olympics or has biographies of Minnesota Olympians, something like that. So, yeah.
Hey, you guys are working great. How long should you be creating the great? So that's a lot.
You should ask my boss. not really.
I'll modify time. You all figure that one out.
This is Donovan. What I can tell you is, we have right now a rough list that we've developed as a team for the rooms that we intend to have live on April 1st when we launch. We are going to have a comprehensive set of genre rooms. Now, these are going to be broad genres. So I'm talking about sci-fi, mystery, western, romance. It's not going to be really granular as in cyberpunk, space opera, steampunk, that kind of thing. We are interested in making those subgenre list rooms in the future, but by April 1st, it's going to be kind of big picture genres. So we will have a comprehensive set of those ready to go. We are intending to have the ebook room functional, but that's going to kind of depend on how Cersei Dynex does with ERC. Like I said, they just rolled that software out about 3 weeks ago, so maybe it'll be ready, maybe it won't. We will have rooms for library hours and contact information if that is something that people want. We already have places up there to have links for that. So that's not something we're sure anyone's going to want, but if anyone does, we will have it. We are going to have a set of holiday rooms, sort of like the genre rooms. It'll be a complete, comprehensive set, but it will be big picture. Easter, Christmas, Valentine's Day, that kind of thing. You know, I don't know that we'll get so granular as Canadian Veterans Day. although that's certainly those kinds of, I shouldn't say sub-holidays, but less common holidays possibly for the future. We are going to have a room set up for the SELCO Professional Collection. That'll be pretty much just on our profile. I don't think any of you are going to want that on yours. Ditto with a room for SELCO kits. And the room for My Discoveries, which will tell people how to go to another Opera Browser catalog and bring their data over. And then we will have some Pathfinder-type rooms, sort of like the employment rooms. That's not really a complete set that I can talk about, so all I can really say is we're going to create as many as we can on topics that we think are useful, and then we will take suggestions for more. Does that sort of help answer the question? Okay. We do sort of have a plan. The plan is evolving. So that actually takes us to the last part of our day, our morning, I should say. We've talked a lot today about testing and feedback, but we haven't really talked a whole lot about how we are going to get that testing and feedback. So let's talk about that. The first component of this is what we're calling user feedback. And if you're not aware of it already, user is the term we tend to use here at SELCO for all of you, library staff, who we consider kind of our primary constituency. You serve your patrons, we serve you, and hopefully make it easier for you to do that job. So our primary mechanism for this is a web-based form, which I'm going to show you in just a few moments. That's run off of a Google group where you will be able to post suggestions, bug reports, why doesn't it do this, it should do that, this doesn't work, those kinds of comments. And the really cool thing about that is you can respond to each other's comments. So someone posts, they want something, you know, it should do this, you can chime in and say, yeah, I agree with that. Or you can chime in and say, I'm not so sure that would be useful at my library. Even if it's just as simple as plus one, which is a convention that you see on a lot of web forums, where someone wants to second what someone else said, but they don't want to write a whole message about it, you can do that. And we'll actually be looking for that. So if you see someone post something that you like, put a reply on there, because we're not going to go so far as to have formal voting on this. But we are definitely interested to see how people's suggestions are flying in the user community. The forum will be open to all SELCO users, so we're not restricting this to just directors, just automation contacts. Anybody will be able to get to this and use it. Technically, patrons can get to it too, but we're not really encouraging that, and we probably won't pay as much attention to that. It's just kind of hard to restrict it that far. One thing that might be a little controversial is we are not going to allow anonymous comments. We feel that we have a community here, and we want to have a frank discussion within that community of what this catalog should be. And I believe transparency dictates that we know who asks for things. This is not the kind of web forum where people are talking about sensitive personal lifestyle things, or a political forum in Syria where you could get killed for saying something. So the usual arguments for anonymity, I don't think, quite apply to a forum for suggestions on the catalog. So we're going to ask you to own your comments. And that applies to us, too. We're not going to be posting things as from SELCO. If I respond to your comment, you're going to know it was me. If it's Tyler, you're going to know it was him. I already mentioned commenting on other posts, which I think is something that is really cool and really important. We will be actively engaged in this forum, but I am going to tell you right now, we intend for it to be driven by you. So we will respond to your comments. Certainly we will say things like, that's a great idea and we're going to do it. But don't look for us to try and drive the conversation, because we have our own ways of communicating amongst ourselves. This is a tool that's for you. And to get to that, like I said, I'll show it to you in just a moment. We've created a shortened URL for that. This will go out as email as well, so don't feel like you have to write it down right this second. tinyurl.com/enterprisefeedback. Usability testing is the second tool that we're going to be using to look at this catalog. How many here have actually come over to SELCO and helped us test our website? There's people in the room who have done that. We're going to be using the same methodology that we did for that. It's from the Web Usability is Not Rocket Surgery book, and I'm mangling that title just a little bit. We set up a series of scenarios. We ask you to go through them. We watch remotely and take notes on what goes well and what doesn't go well. The site's being tested, not you. That worked really well for us as we were redesigning our website. Once now that the website is up, we're going to actually start doing those again. So you may hear from us on that, some of you. We're going to use the same methodology for this, possibly with some modifications, because we're going to try to carry it out at libraries. We're not going to make you come here to do that. We'll be coming out to you. So very soon, as in the next few days, you're going to be getting an email from me saying, who wants to be a partner library and have us come out there with the whole circuit and set up usability testing? We would like to do testing with both library staff, our users, as well as patrons. And that's where we're going to be looking to our partner libraries to help us with the identifying and inviting people from your patron base to come in and do some searches or run through some other scenarios. Can you figure out my account? Can you search things? How do you limit your search to just DVDs? That kind of thing. So we want to do some testing with you. We want to do some testing with patrons. And hopefully that will give us a complete idea of where we need to go. We're looking to do 2 sessions with library staff and 2 with patrons. That's our target. If we can manage to fit in 3 apiece, that would be really awesome, but we've only got 2 months to work with, and there is a certain amount of logistics that goes into this. We'll be sending several people to your library to conduct the session. So we will try to get at least 4 of them in. We'll shoot for 6. When I send the email out to you soon, it'll have a more complete list of what are the requirements, what kind of room do we need, equipment, all that kind of stuff. And as I said, we will conduct the testing and work with you on the space. And then finally, we should talk about training. Training is not really a feedback mechanism, but it's something that I'm sure everyone wants to know about. We're going to approach training much the same way we did with Aqua Browser. We're not going to be doing classroom training, per se. We will be creating a number of short online video segments that cover specific pieces of functionality. Searching, My Account, eBooks. These are all targeted to be about 5 minutes long. Some of them might get a little longer depending on what it is, but 5 is really our target. Along with corresponding written documentation that will also be posted for people who want to sort of follow along with the video, or maybe people who just prefer to work off the printed page as opposed to a video. That way, everything you've seen today and more will be out there as a video, and you can watch us, and you can watch that video as many times as you want. You can freeze it, rewind it, do whatever. After we launch on April 1st, we will conduct road shows as requested. I don't know if everyone here is familiar with the road shows, but that's where we come out to your library and do training for your staff, training that has been more or less personalized for what you're looking for. We do this a lot with ebooks, and I know a lot of you here have had us do that at your library, where we'll come out, you can tell us ahead of time, here's the points on ebooks that I really need you to address, and we'll come out and do that. So we'll supplement the training with road shows as needed, and if necessary, we can certainly do some more training at the May Technology Users Group meeting, which will be about a month after the catalog launches. So before I go to the forums and show you how that's going to work, how do you get to Enterprise? We've created a shortened URL for that. This is it.
URL.
Thank you.
Yes. I'll fix that for the next meeting. Thank you very much. Yes, that should be tinyurl.com/SELCO-Enterprise. That will take you straight to the SELCO Enterprise profile. From there, there is a drop-down menu where you can go to look at your library's specific profile. I would encourage you to check it out as frequently as you can for the next 2 months, because things are going to be changing, and they're going to be changing fast. We've reached the point of our implementation where we think that it's about, I don't know, what would you say, about 80% ready? And then that remaining 20% is going to be a lot of tweaking, a lot of polishing, fixing of known issues, a lot of stuff where we have to go to all of you and ask for your input. What do you want for your graphic? Do you like the current graphic, or do you want a different one? What kind of rooms do you want on your profile? What are the facets that you're going to want to use after those three that are there by default? All that kinds of stuff. That's a lot of what's going to be happening in the next 2 weeks. So keep an eye on it. We'll try to post to the forums to kind of give you some idea when big changes happen, but it's going to be rapidly evolving. So you'll want to keep an eye on it. Keep an eye on the forums. Post early, post often. Let us know what you're thinking. I'll send this out as email as well. So if you don't get it written down, we'll get it out to you. Now, the forums. If I can find the forums with all this stuff. That's not it.
Sorry, I have a bazillion tabs open.
That's okay. Not a big deal. That's okay. So the link for that, as I said, is tinyurl.com/enterprise-feedback. Now, because this is a Google group, it's going to look differently depending on whether you're logged into a Google account or not. And we'll talk about some of those details in just a moment. But as you can see here, we have our little welcome message. There is a link, or there will be a link to the catalog. We haven't got that in there yet. It'll go in this afternoon after the second meeting. And here are a series of topics that we've already got in there. Some of these are testing ones that we did before today. I think some of these might be real ones that have come in over the course of this meeting. No? Okay.
Later from this morning when I'm finishing up my video.
Okay. So what will happen is we'll be clearing out all those testing ones so that we have a nice blank slate tomorrow when we start doing this in earnest. But as you can see a list of the topics. You can see how many posts there are in the given thread. So we'll take a look at this one by clicking on it. RG something something something. The emails are truncated. posted, will Enterprise be using the same kind of facets we were using for Opera Browser? And RG responded to her own post, or anyone else could respond to that as well. I need to look at my notes now to make sure I don't overlook anything. Let's go ahead and make a post, which you do right up here with the red new topic button. Make it look more like Star Trek, because after all, it is called Enterprise. Make it so. Yeah, nerd alert.